Live on TNT Sports, let's first welcome to the ring the challenger and former world champion, Isaac Royal Storm Dogbay.
So here is the former world champion, Isaac Dogbay, a man used to big nights and big fights, and one who still feels he's one of the best in the division. He also knows if he wins tonight, another world title might not be too far away.
My mystery box is somewhere very near. I feel it inside me, I'm feeling very weird. Something where I didn't chase, but years back in the days, you told me I would see this black world, but now I won't believe you. No, but how far would I be? Yeah. I'm too close, I can feel it. Something is vibrating inside me, I'm celebrating. And outside they kill me.
He's a man who's been here before, Richie, been here many times in situations like this, and he's just doing everything here at his pace.
Very experienced, isn't he, by world title fights, and his three defeats have come in world title fights also. So, yes, he's action-packed. He's very similar to Nick Ball, actually. Nick Ball acknowledges that. So, you know, that makes for an explosive fight, but his experience, and I think, yes, on paper, this is Nick Ball's toughest fight, no question, but yeah, he's a good operator, this fella, Isaac Dogbay.
It's a fascinating fight. You like the experience and the know-how, the man with the top-class experience and the world championship belts. Well, the new kid on the block and so green determined, the fighter desperate to get to the top of the mountain. It's all there for us tonight.
The only thing I would say also, actually, he's been in a few really hard fights. How much is actually left? I think we'll find out tonight, because I think he's going to be pushed by Nick Ball. Can't wait for this one.
And now let's welcome to the ring the undefeated defending champion, Nick the Wrecking Ball.
What an opportunity for Liverpool's Nick Ball. It's the biggest fight of his career, a fight that can take him closer to his dream. He's exciting, he's a puncher, and he's determined to put himself in a world title fight with a victory in Manchester.
Ranked number one by the WBC, number five by the IBF, and number six by the WBO. So well recognised, very explosive. I think he's probably the most exciting fighter in British boxing today, arguably. Nick Ball, very explosive and action packed.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout is scheduled for 12 rounds and it'll be for the WBC Silver Featherweight Championship, and it is a final eliminator for the WBC Featherweight World Championship. Brought to you by Frank Warren on behalf of Queensberry in association with Bob Arum's Top Rank Incorporated, along with their great sponsors, 32 Red and Unibet. It is sanctioned by the British Boxing Board of Control, Steward in Charge Robin Smith, along with the World Boxing Council, President Mauricio Suleiman, Supervisor Robert W. Smith, Timekeeper is Andrew East. Our three judges assigned, all from England, will be Mark Lyson, Kieran McCann, and Kevin Parker. Our referee in charge will be Victor Loughlin of Scotland. Introducing to you first the challenger, fighting tonight out of the red corner. He comes to the ring wearing white with red and weighed in officially at 8 stone, 13 pounds. fighting out of London, England, by way of Accra, Ghana. He has a professional record consisting of 24 wins, 3 defeats, with 15 of his 24 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the former WBO Super Bantamweight Champion of the World, Isaac Royal Storm Dogman! And his opponent across the ring, he is the defending champion, fighting tonight out of the blue corner. He comes to the ring wearing black with silver and weighed in the same as his opponent, 8 stone, 13 pounds. Hailing from Liverpool, England, he is undefeated with 18 wins. 11 of his 18 wins come by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the highly ranked and reigning and defending WBC Silver Featherweight Champion, Nick the Wrecking Ball!
Okay, gents, you've had your instructions. Remember, obey my commands at all time, defend yourselves at all time. God bless, touch them.
Well, this one could be a cracker. The winner fights for the world title. Two men who love to come forward and meet their opponent head on. Dogbe has the experience. He's a former world champion of super bantamweight and fought for the WBO featherweight title in his last fight. Balls on a roll. A man with real momentum, real confidence, and a growing reputation, Richie.
Indeed. Very explosive, isn't he, Nick Ball? And against a mirror image, really, in terms of his opponent. He's very similar in height and is an explosive puncher himself. And there's an example of that, that right hand downstairs. So yes, this one should be a cracker.
The big question is, how much does Dogbe have left? The difference in experience is stark, and Ball already looking to get to work and land solid shots. Dogbe happy to cover up and take those punches. Dogbe's fought 184 rounds as a professional compared to 78 for Ball. He's been the 12 round distance 5 times, had 5 world title fights prior to tonight, and been in some excellent high profile contests. It's the night, I think, we find out so much more about what's inside Nick Ball.
I think you're right, Fletch. The punch that will be important here for Nick Ball tonight will be his jab, actually, to try and open his opponent up. Dogbe, very experienced, starting this contest high guard. There's not a lot getting through, you see there, hitting the arms, hitting the gloves. He's been around the block a few times, this fella, and he knows his way around the ring. So the jab for Nick Ball to prise open this guard and get to his man, that may be crucial.
These are heavy shots in the early round from Nick Ball, a lot of them being taken on the arms and the gloves of Isaac Dogbe. Just lands, tries to land a couple of his own there in this opening round. Both of them short in stature, but extremely solid individuals that put together well, a pair of them, Richie, aren't they?
Yes, indeed. Dogbe again there, some good shots going in from Ball, a couple got through. But Dogbe, like I've said, Fletch, experienced, and blocking a lot of these shots.
He's the kind of man, Nick Ball, who throws hurtful shots in the first round. In the mid rounds, he's still throwing them, and then when you get the legs around, he's still got the power to hurt
them.
Never loses it, does he, during a fight?
Stays relaxed throughout the contest. I think just sheer on sheer volume of punches in this round, he's had the better of it up to now, anyway.
Ball's being the aggressive, but that high guard is serving Dogbe well in there at the moment, tucking his arms by his sides when Ball goes to the body and keeping those gloves tight when he targets the head.
He's showing his talent there as well. Ball just switches from orthodox to southpaw. He operates critters quite well as a southpaw. They just got caught there, the feet cross. He got caught with the right hand.
Dogbe, good combination there. Hurtful shots that he was landing. And there's the bell to end the first round, and both of them just laying down a marker against the other one there in the first. Well, Mick Paul stopped his last five opponents and seems to be getting better with every challenge. He says this is a fight where the toughest man will survive. Dogbay lost his last fight, a challenge for the WBO featherweight title in April against the two-time Olympic champion, Rebese Ramirez. On points, he was down in the 12th in that one, but he's operated at the top level for a long time now.
And he was always in that fight, Fletch, against Robson Ramirez, the Olympic champion. So yes, no disgrace in losing that one. Like we've said before, he's only lost world title fights, so yeah, he knows what he's doing.
He's dealing with the likes of Emmanuel Navarrete twice, a memorable battle with Jesse Magdaleno. It's just a case of how much he's got left. Dogbay, he's only 29, 27 fights, 3 defeats. Richie's mentioned, and Nick Paul is very much a young man on the rise.
A bit of a more faster start from Dogbay in this round, and that's just made Ball work a little bit harder also.
Good solid work by Ball in there. Is Paulum and Paul Stevenson the same between rounds? It's a good start. You've taken control early. Keep doing what you're doing. He's been very accurate with these shots so far. He's needed that tight defence, hasn't he, Dogbay?
He has indeed, but at the same time, Ball's working well in terms of volume of punches. Changes from orthodox to southpaw occasionally. Got to watch that, though, Fletch. You're in against a man who knows what he's doing and will watch out for that switch and maybe try and catch him if his legs cross.
Ball finds himself in a corner. Trying to land that long right hand that just missed. It's a good shot by Nick Paul. He was just slightly off balance there, Dogbay. Just wondered if he was going to wilt under the pressure, but he just got his feet crossed a little bit.
Sensible there from Ball. Switch from southpaw to orthodox, but he did it going backwards rather than coming forward and making the feet cross.
Body shot from Dogbay inside the final minute of the second round. This is for the WBC silver belt, but it's more significantly a final eliminator for the WBC featherweight title. Ray Vargas is the champion, but he's been operating at super feather.
Interesting this early stuff from Ball on that front foot. He's literally taking the contest to Dogbay and making him exchange. So he's actually making Dogbay work here. Dogbay quite content just to sit back with a high guard, but Ball's been coming more and more forward in this round and putting it on him.
Ball just catching Dogbay high on top of his head. It's been another decent round here for Ball. Started well. Both of them are loading. Good shot by Dogbay. Ball's legs were wobbled. That's a really good shot by Dogbay right at the end of that round. Oh. And I just thought for a second there that Ball's legs buckled a little bit.
Yeah, he was caught with a tremendous, I think it was the left hook. What a belting shot that was. So that just reminded Ball that he's in a fight here. That was good stuff at the end of the round. Let's have a look. It's a left hook there, right hand, and I'm sure another left hook comes in just here. There's the shot there. So a belting shot that is. And yes, Nick Ball, maybe he's off balance, I don't know. Let's have a look at it here. Let's give Dogbay credit. Yes, that's a belting shot. Yes, he is leaning back. And his legs just go momentarily there. Good punch there from Dogbay.
Well, that's the best punch of the fight from either of them so far. Credit to Nick Ball for taking it as well as he did. And interestingly, he spent the entire minute between rounds standing in the corner, didn't feel the need to sit down. He's clearly recovered nice and quickly, and he's out for work here at the start of the third. It's just a warning, though, that Dogbay, with all his experience and all his ability, isn't just going to roll over in there tonight.
No, but Ball, like I said, she's making Dogbay exchange a little bit more now, and Dogbay actually came forward and pushed Ball back a little bit there with that left hook especially, so it was good work from Dogbay. Will it be a similar tactic now from Ball?
Ball's from the same place in Liverpool as former world champions Paul Hodgkinson and John Conte. He intends to be the next man to take a world championship belt back to Merseyside.
That was a shot over the top, a right hand over the top there. Dogbay complained it was sort of towards the back of the head. It might have been just towards the ear, his left ear. But nevertheless, he was troubled by that. I think Nick Ball, when he's in close range here, Fletch, he's got to watch out for the left up from Dogbay. That's the danger shot. He really whips it in. Good punches from Ball. Looking to the body, Dogbay behind that tight guard. Nick Ball happy to unload, he'll keep punching all night. Firing in a double jab and then following it up with a right hand as well, Nick Ball. Good work from him, relentless pressure from the man from Liverpool. Yeah, it's good stuff from Ball, but doesn't want to get complacent. Dogbay keeping that guard high again, good work from Ball, excellent with that left hook. Ball looking to keep the pressure on, looking to mix up the attacks to head and body. He's been very accurate so far tonight. Really motivated for this one, Nick Ball. Yeah, great switch of attack that, wasn't it, from Ball. Went from the body and then the left uppercut due to the head. Wasn't too far away. Excellent combination again from him. Ball is supremely fit. He'll stand toe-to-toe all night if that's what he needs to do. And he's trying to gradually break down Isaac Dogbay in there. Bullies him into the corner, shows his strength, looks to unload, looks to apply the pressure, and looks to prove that he's the man in there tonight. Dogbay made the fatal mistake there, Fletch, of just showing the opponent that he was hurt by a shot. It was a shot earlier, it was a right hand that got through the guard of Dogbay, and he just went back a little bit, and that invited then Ball to come in and land another couple of big shots. First signs there that Dogbay was in trouble with a couple of shots there. 40 seconds to go in the third round. Body shots coming in from Dogbay, rips in that left hook as well, and then the right hand. Nick Ball beckons him in, both of them happy to have the tear up in there. Ball goes through the gears again and Dogbay has to take a backward step. Tremendous stuff, isn't it? It's that type of contest where you've got to watch what you're doing. Even when you're on the attack, you keep your opponent on that back foot with these hard shots. Dogbay's the type to come back. Ball, of course, as he came in right at the end of the round. No knockdown. They started a count at ringside, but Victor Loughlin said no. And for the second round in succession, right at the end, Nick Ball was caught. Unbelievable. Concentration right at the end of the round there.
He's just all over. Yeah, listen, nice and busy with the work, what you're doing. He doesn't like it, you know what I mean? He's not coming back with much.
Let's have a look at here. As a southpaw, misses the target there, just walks on there to that shot. It wasn't really a punch on the chin, wasn't it? I think it was more of the shoulder, but I think because he's coming forward, but just misses. So he's a southpaw, he misses with that left hand and almost walked onto one. Didn't quite. So no, it didn't even hit his chin, Fletcher. You know, it wasn't a count.
Hence why Victor Loughlin waves the count off. He was right on the spot to see it, of course.
Good refereeing.
It's the beauty of the replay, so everybody at home can see it, because in real time, depending on the angle, difficult to spot. This has been really good so far, the kind of fight that we expected it to be. Fourth round and the first three have been all action.
They have indeed. For me, Ball has taken these rounds.
Oh, he's giving, he's giving the knockdown.
Interesting to see that on the good place.
So a standing eight count for Dogbay. Nick Ball straight back to work.
The type of contest that you've got to concentrate in this situation. You're in against a tough opponent. And Ball, it's going all one way at the moment, but this Dogbay is still dangerous.
Great left hand by Ball. Really solid shot, bullies Dogbay into the corner again. Victor Loughlin dives in to split them up. Nick Ball desperate to get back at it. Dogbay responds with a left hand of his own. Fantastic fight to this point, Richie.
Tremendous, great shot from Ball, wasn't it? Left hook, the second time in the contest where Dogbay has really felt the power of Ball. And you can actually physically see him wilt from that shot.
Dogbay missing with the initial punch, but then landed a body shot. Ball then puts the punches together. He's been the one throwing punches in bunches, hasn't he, Ball? They've been single shots in the main from Dogbay.
Yeah, short to mid-range, then Ball really... he's dangerous, isn't he? Look at that, and a switch of attack. That's good work again from Ball. Go from the body, then a right uppercut through the middle.
Just a little dip of the knees at the end of the attack from Dogbay, who's certainly feeling it in there.
Yeah, and Ball is relentless, isn't he? But again, got to work with the jab. Keep peppering that shot into Dogbay. Keep him off balance, keep making him think.
50 seconds to go in the four. Nick Ball just slightly too high with that one, but straight back to work again. The one thing Dogbay doesn't want is to get trapped in a corner.
See, Nick Ball keeps switching.
Oh, great uppercut! Body shot set it off, and then he knifed that uppercut between the guard and Dogbay. Great punch from Ball.
Switch of attack, wasn't it, to the body, then that right uppercut. Referee not happy, though, with the wrestling from Nick Ball.
Crowd inside the Manchester Arena not happy that Victor Loughlin slowed it down. Nick Ball straight to it. Dogbay on the ropes, went for the body and head combination again. Didn't quite get the uppercut through. Good jab from Dogbay.
Ball got to keep that right hand in nice and high when he's in close. Dogbay still dangerous with that short to mid-range left hook on the inside.
And there's the bell.
Super stuff from Nick Ball again. The left up there, it was more of a shove, wasn't it? Have a look from a different angle, but the referee give the count. That's a 10-8 round. Let's have a look at it here. I mean, that's not a bad shot. It actually hits the gloves there. But Nick Ball just piling on the pressure. Sustains the attacks, keeps it going. This is where he gets a little bit naughty with the wrestling, but just throws Dogbay around. What must Isaac Dogbay be thinking when his opponent does that, feeling the strength of his opponent? But this is a lovely bit of work. Right hand to the body, and then he switches that right uppercut straight to the middle to the head. Switch of attack, perfect stuff.
Yeah. Dogbay's a fascinating character. He's from one of the royal families in Ghana, hence the nickname Royal Storm. He's an A-level student and an Olympian at the age of 17. And he's gone on to have a fantastic career in the professional ranks, but he's got a real battle on his hands here against this ultra-motivated man from Liverpool in Nick Ball. Every punch he's thrown in there tonight is a punch designed to end the fight, and he's going to do that for 12 rounds, regardless of what happens in there.
That's good work again from Nick Ball. The only thing I would say, Fletcher said this before, you must concentrate in this type of a contest. You're in against a tough opponent who can punch himself. He's boxed at world level, remember, and he's dangerous. Ball, it's going all Ball's way at the moment. He's doing really well, but he's just got to keep it going.
Talk about the difference in experience. Ball had been a pro for less than a year by the time that Dogbay was a world champion. Good shots again from Ball. He's putting those combinations together so impressively tonight. Dogbay's turn to launch an attack. Ball immediately back, though. I think he's made his mind up tonight, Nick Ball, that he's not prepared to take a backward step.
No. And Dogbay, he's obviously having to go himself there. He's actually a little bit more vulnerable when he's throwing shots, especially the right hand over the top from Ball. And Ball's going for it again. And Dogbay jabs out. Then Ball has the chance to land that right hand over the top. But this is better for Dogbay.
Ball's clearly the stronger man in there. Whenever he wants to bully Dogbay, he's able to push him back to the ropes or get him into a corner. A little bit more than a minute to go in the fifth round, scheduled for 12. The winner gets a world title shot. That's what's on the line for these two men tonight. Dogbay's been there before. Nick Ball wants to taste the big time for the very first time.
There's signs from Dogbay that is he just slowing down a little bit? Is he feeling the pace, Dogbay? I actually think this has been one of his better rounds You just see signs of the odd slow jab here and there. And just him taking in a few deep breaths. Just waiting for the next attack from Ball.
If there are any stamina doubts about an opponent, Nick Ball is the ideal man to find it. Ball goes lunging in, landing the left hand in there, but not one that packs too much in the way of power. Don't forget Nathan Heaney against Denzel Bentley. The co-main event comes after this one. Two cracking fights at the top of the bill tonight here in Manchester. This one living up to all the expectation as we hear the sound of the bell. Welcome back to the Manchester Arena where Paul Stevenson is talking in Nick Ball's corner. The main crux of it, Richie, between rounds, was just keep breaking him down. I think that's the plan tonight, just gradually break Dogbe down.
Patience and break him down, yeah. Sensible coaching there from Paul Stevenson. You know what he's talking about.
So out for the sixth round here in the Manchester Arena. Atmosphere in here is crackling. They're really enjoying the build tonight, the magnificent seven. Most of the fights have lived up to the pre-fight expectations, and Nick Ball certainly going about his business well. He landed a really solid right in there, but full credit to Dogbe. He seems to find a way back regardless of what situation he's in.
He's got a great chin, hasn't he? Taking a couple of big shots. He comes firing back, just inviting the right hand again from Nick Ball with that low lead hand of his. Nick Ball, he's relentless, isn't he? He will not leave Dogbe alone. Well, that's a good response there from Dogbe.
Ball continues to chop away at Dogbe, continues to try and break his resistance, break his spirit. The punching machine, isn't he? Never stops. Attack after attack after attack in there. The volume of his work is so impressive.
Yeah, on that front foot. And yes, he's dictating things. But, Dogbe, to his credit, has taken everything that Ball has thrown. He's still in there.
Nathan Heaney fans in full voice all around the arena. Nick Ball and Isaac Dogbe doing their thing here in the co-main event. Dogbe with his back to the ropes. Nick Ball waits, patient, waits for the opening, hits the uppercut.
What I liked about that attack there, Fletch, was he pushed Dogbe on that throw in the ropes there, then got the guard, his right hand right back straight to the odd guard position to get his hands up nice and high. So he's thinking about defence also, Nick Ball.
Dogbe's big problem here, Richie, is when he tries to open up himself, he's just met by a barrage from Ball in return.
The pressure of the two, isn't it, Ball? Clearly. He cannot rise, Dogbe. Not just yet, still dangerous.
Attacking to body and head again. He's mixed up those attacks really impressively tonight.
And the variety of downstairs. And he switches to that right at the foot through the middle. He knows what he's doing. And I think Dogbe, yes. Good sign here and there that he's feeling it, definitely.
Well, there's the bell. Let's bring in Carl Frampton, who's watching it from the presentation position and scoring the fight as well. I mean, it's what we thought it might be, Carl.
Yeah, in terms of scorecard, it's pretty one-sided, but like some of the rounds are competitive, but I think what's really impressed me here about Nick Ball, and I've sparred Isaac Dogbe, and I've sparred maybe 200 rounds with him at least. He's physically very, very strong, but Nick Ball is manhandling him like I've never seen before. Picking his shots well, and I mean, it's a long way back for Dogbe here.
Thank you, Carl. I mean, I think you concur with all of that, Richie. I mean, it has been quite startling, has it? The way that he's been manhandled around the ring. We picked up on that two or three times when he's been bullied into the ropes or thrown into a corner.
Absolutely, you know, Dogbay's a former world champion and he's fought at world level, but there he's just been thrown around, like Carl has said, and that would have surprised him. He wouldn't have expected that from Nick Ball.
Ball quit being a plasterer with his dad in Liverpool to concentrate on his boxing career. He's now got his own clothing range and designs on leaving an indelible mark on the sport. And he's been very impressive here. Carl Frampton's got it a shutout with a 10-8 round thrown in for Nick Ball to this stage as we move into the seventh round of this 12-rounder in what is a final eliminator for the WBC featherweight title.
Well, it is one-sided, but at the same time, you know that Dogbay is still dangerous. You know, he's still got that power. And who knows? That's why, like I said before, the concentration, you've got to keep it going in a contest like this. Ball is boxing superbly well.
Good body work from Ball, and then a good shot to the head at the end of the combination. And Brandon Figueroa is the interim champion at the moment. I mentioned that Ray Vargas has been fighting at super feather, but he's still the WBC champion. But there is going to be an opportunity for the winner of this one. Nick Ball doing everything asked of him at this stage. Excellent work by Ball, finished off by the uppercut.
Yeah, excellent. Lead uppercut right at the end of that exchange. The best shot there.
A smile on the face of Ball, and he beckons Dogbay in.
Dogbay actually caught him with a good shot there and made him go back a little bit. But Ball back on that front foot again. See, that's good boxing, just staying more at mid-range for the power shot. But he's not leaning in, so he's not falling in on his work. And that's when Dogbay could come back with that short left-up counter, you see. So it's good work there from Ball. Well balanced, not falling in. Good mid-range boxing power shots there.
Dogbay looking to try and put his punches together. We've not seen too much of that tonight. Not too many combinations from the very experienced former world champion. 20 seconds to go in the seventh. He just caught there, Ball. Yeah, balanced as he came in, that sweeping right hand.
Made that mistake there again. He's boxing as a southpaw there. He's trying to lead with his backhand, and he falls in. He misses the target, gets away with it, really. Dogbay just wasn't accurate with the counter, but he's got to watch out for that. He's been caught with that move a couple of times tonight, Nick Ball. The odd mistake here and there.
So the co-main event tonight, after this one, the British middleweight title fight between Nathan Heaney and Denzel Bentley. And this really is the biggest night of Nathan Heaney's boxing career. The crowd are in here warming their voices up to see their man make his now famous ring walk. And he's going to try and surprise everybody and beat Denzel Bentley tonight, Richie.
Tough job, but he's going to give it everything, Nathan. And, you know, he's confident. And you never know with the crowd behind him. But like I said, I think Denzel Bentley is a good champion. It should be a good fight.
You need to make it good on your hair.
Yeah.
All right.
Blue one.
Blue one.
I think to emphasise, Richie, just how much Nick Ball keeps punching in fights. His last three fights have been two 12th-round stoppages and one first-round knockout. So at either end of the fight, he's powerful and he's relentless.
Good engine, stays relaxed throughout the contest, produces power shots late in the contest, as you just said, Fletch. So, yes, this is a real handful. Dogbay is coming out here. Bit better from him at the opening of this round.
This is the eighth. It must be in Dogbay's mind that he must be a mile behind on the cards. He's got to do something to try and turn this fight in his favour. Got to do something to try and make Nick Ball make a backward step. He's got to give Ball problems that he can't deal with. When those little gaps do appear, he's got to be ready to strike.
Good work there, some ball again. Jabs to the body, then jab to the head. Better response there from Dogbay. That wasn't too bad from him. To be patient in there in this round, then he lands a really good right hand.
Yeah, it is indeed. Dogbay just made the mistake there of just switching to southpaw, and he got caught. So he tried to switch to southpaw like Nick Ball's been doing, but gets caught with a super shot there from Ball.
When you talk about the difference in experience between the two of them in terms of the kind of levels that Dogbay's been mixing in, and the fact that he's a former world champion, it's been a very mature performance in there tonight from Ball, hasn't it?
I think he's been mature, he's been patient, he's listened to his corner, and yes, up to now it's been a good performance from Nick Ball. He's been pretty dominant, and he's in against a real dangerous guy.
30 seconds to go in the eighth, and Dogbay was wobbling, whether it was off balance. Legs were just starting to betray him. Lands a decent body shot though, by way of reply.
Wasn't too bad at all from Dogbay. There's a good right hand over the top, went in from him, and then switched downstairs with a couple of good body shots himself. So he's just still showing that Nick Ball that he's still in this contest.
Ball switching from body to head and then back to the body again. That uppercut he likes to uncork, doesn't he, when he's targeted the body, and there's the bell to end the eighth. Monkey. It's a new trainer in there tonight, Jeff Rayal. He's the assistant to Virgil Hunter, so a different voice in there tonight for Isaac Dogbay.
It's too close right now. It's too close. He's doing the right shots, but you gotta keep coming on his ass. Hold your ground a little more. Alright?
I'm moving too much.
No, you need to keep moving, but I'm saying hold your ground when he comes forward.
Okay.
Just let your hands go.
Alright?
Richie, I think that's okay in theory, but he's a difficult man, isn't he, to hold your ground against Nick Ball.
Difficult to actually keep him at bay, isn't it? Because Nick Ball's on that front foot, pushing the fight to Isaac Dogbay. Yes, difficult indeed to hold your ground, because you know he's going to come for you, Nick Ball.
So four rounds to go, and unofficially, you take Carl Frampton's scorecard into account, Nick Ball is a mile ahead. Territory where Isaac Dogbay would need a stoppage to win, or certainly some big 10-8 rounds at the end of this contest, unofficially of course, but the eye test tells you that there's been a gap between the two of them tonight. Dogbay up on his toes here at the start of the night.
Yeah, change of tactic, but not what his corner wanted. But nevertheless, he's opting to hit and to move a little bit more. Maybe that will confuse Nick Ball, or just try and find a way of keeping Ball at bay, I suppose. That's what he's doing.
Good work by Ball again. He must be a nightmare to be in there against, because he's so physically strong, isn't he? You can't bully him by any stretch of the imagination.
A strong kid, isn't he? Oh, great variety. Look at that uppercut through the middle, and then keeps the attack going.
Super shot. It's been a really good punch for him tonight, that uppercut.
So Dogbay back to the usual tactics. Standing a lot more, started this round up on his toes, but that soon slowed down.
Excellent body shot that was sent in by Ball as well. Showed really good resilience in there tonight, Dogbay, because he's taken some meaty shots and lots of them,
during the course of the fight to this point. Minutes ago in the ninth.
Again, clever boxing there from Ball, because he keeps switching from orthodox to southpaw, but he does it going backwards, Flex. So his feet, obviously your feet will cross when you switch stances, but if you get caught with a shot when you're moving away, it takes the power out of the punch. So he's been well schooled, Nick Ball, you can see it.
Ball starting the attack with an uppercut again. Oh, there's another one, a left uppercut ripped through the guard once more. Sharp work from Dogbay, but he just takes it, Nick Ball, and then comes back firing himself.
That wasn't too bad from Dogbay, but the response from Nick Ball.
Oh, oh, good shot.
There you go, Fletch.
Very, very solid from Dogbay, and he just took a deep breath and just held on for a second, didn't he, Ball?
Yeah.
There's the class of Dogbay, still in there.
Still there, and we spoke about it right through this contest. The left hook, he's got to watch out for the left hook. Nick Ball, and he gets caught with one there. So what an end to this round again from Dogbay.
Dogbay looking to put the pressure on, and Ball might just be happy to hear the bell. He gives him that long lingering stare at the end of the round, but as you've said time and again in this fight, Nick Ball might be controlling it, but this is a former world champion, a talented guy, and when the opportunity comes, he can be dangerous.
Very dangerous indeed. Let's have a look at it here. So it's a left hook. We spoke about it earlier in the contest that Nick Ball's got to watch out for that shot. Got caught right at the end of the round. The good left hook. Cracking shot. And just a little wake-up call again for Nick Ball. Dogbay still in the contest.
He's old school though, Rich. He never sits down. Stands up between rounds.
Hey ref, come on, he's pushing.
For those 10 seconds.
Oh, is there a problem with Dogbay?
I think he was concerned, Jeff Real, about some of the tactics of Ball in the round. I think he was questioning Victor Lachlan about whether he's letting too much go in there. There's three to go, round 10. Dogbay looking to start fast here in the 10th round.
Yeah, he's come out as a southpaw here, Dogbay, putting his punches together. Oh, that's a good shot again from him. So that left hook in that previous round has given him a bit of confidence, Fletch.
Needs a massive finish though, doesn't he? Ball starts to chop away again.
Oh, lovely work.
Excellent variety again.
That was lovely, really was. Two downstairs to the body, then that left uppercut again that hit the target. Finding the space and the gap through the middle and hitting the target. That's the hard thing to do, and he did that really well there.
Good work by Ball to get in and get out again before Dogbay could counter.
Just got to watch out for that left hook from Dogbay. That's Ball. He's dominant again. Dogbay is showing that he's a world-class fighter.
I think to counter that, though, Richie, Nick Ball is also showing tonight that he is very much a world-class fighter.
100%. And at this level, in the 10th round, and both fighters are extremely dangerous with either punch. But it's been mainly one-way traffic, with Dogbay still in there.
It's been a dominant performance up to now from Nick Ball, who has had to take a couple of sharp shots from Dogbay on occasions, but the better work, the more impressive work, the better scoring shots, the pressure has all come from Nick Ball. Big, big night for him, but he's handled it so well. Good left hand from Ball. What a shot that was.
Yeah, that was a great shot, but before that as well, working well with the jab, maintaining the gap, in and out with the feet. Some lovely boxing, and Dogbay comes back with another big shot.
Ball's like a man possessed. The minute he smells blood, he wants to bully Dogbay all around the ring. Victor Lachlan just calming him down. 40 seconds to go in the 10th. Ball continues to land those uppercuts at will. Full credit to Dogbay, who's showing an iron chin in there tonight.
Yeah, he's a tough guy, he really is. I bet no one's thrown him around the ring like Nick Ball has, though, even in world title fights.
There's the blood on the face of Nick Ball, though, which has happened in this round. I'm not sure if it's damage to the nose, Richie. Final a few seconds here at the 10th, and then we can have a proper look. Maybe not. beautiful finishing the round with a little bit of a combination, a little flurry at the end. There's Carl Frampton's card, Richie. He's just actually given Isaac Dogbe his first round of the fight, so he's a mile behind. Look, 9 points on Carl's card, which is unofficial, of course, but I think the general consensus around ringside here is that the lead is pretty substantial for Ball.
Yes, most definitely. Nothing to argue with that. And for such a one-sided fight, it's still quite exciting because you know that Dogbe is still in the contest and he's very capable indeed of producing a power shot himself.
Two to go. They were just dabbing away at the nose of Nick Paul between rounds. There is a bit of blood flowing from there, but nothing serious. All he's got to do now is finish the job, get himself to the final bell. Doesn't need to be a hero at this stage. And then he can start thinking about a WBC world title shot in 2024. He's done everything right so far tonight, carried out the game plan to perfection and been very aggressive in there. Put his punches together like that superbly, hasn't he? Every round we've seen impressive combinations from Nick Ball.
Yeah, the variety from Ball has been brilliant, it really has. Sustained pressure. Fighting on the inside at short range is so difficult to do. He just finds the space and the gaps. And with that variety in his work, yeah, he's very good on the inside.
Remember, Ball's had a couple of late stoppages in recent fights, and Dogbe was down late in his last fight as well, so don't be surprised if there's another twist in the plot at some stage. Halfway through the 11, Dogbe missing with the right hand.
He didn't miss earlier, that was a good shot from Dogbe as Nick Ball came forward. Nick Ball there. Again, just keeping and maintaining that gap, not falling in. And that's what Dogbe would want him to do, you see, falling so he can come back with the odd short, fast counter. Not happening. Look at this work again from Ball. Just maintaining that gap again, lovely stuff.
Super work, great variety to the body and the head, good left hook as well that got through. Two supremely fit men in there. I mean, the condition of the pair of them outstanding. It's why they can fight at this pace at this stage. It's why they can both take the kind of shots they have tonight and just see them bounce off in the main. Seconds to go in the penultimate round. Uppercut from Ball. And again, really tight guard though from Dogbe, but he manages to get one through in the end.
Yeah, what a shot that was. What a super little punch that was, that right uppercut. Right hand to the body, then right uppercut through to the head. Dogbe taking them all. Tough, tough man.
Right uppercut with his back to the ropes then from Ball. And there's the bell. Let's bring in Carl Frampton. I mean, Carl, this has been so impressive, hasn't it, on so many levels from Nick Ball.
I think he's looked really, really good. I think, look, Isaac Dogbe has actually looked good on occasion as well, but only in short periods of rounds. So it's not enough to give him a round. And that's why the scorecards are so weighed. I want to be trying to give Isaac something here, but I can't just give a sympathy everything round, you know what I mean? And Nick Ball, I think his jab's really good, his punch selection is good, and his strength, I mean, the kid's super, super strong. I've never seen anything like it.
How impressed have you been, Carl, by the way he's put those combinations together? Because his variety of punches have been so impressive.
Yeah, the variety's been great, Fletch. He's been picking shots, he's been driving them up through the middle, little short jabs, long jabs, going to the body well. Yeah, an excellent performance so far.
So both men ready for the 12th and final round. Carl Frampton's card is wide in Nick Ball's favour. And it's a case of seeing the job out. Let's see whether there's a miracle finish for Isaac Dogbe or whether Nick Ball can get the late stoppage. And he's been known to do that on occasions. He's been really good tonight.
Yeah, just holding the concentration there through this round. You're in against a dangerous opponent. You've won almost every round. And just getting over the line there, seeing the job out. mean, to get a stoppage would be the icing on the cake, it really would. This fella's only been stopped once in the 12-round world title fight against Emmanuel Navarrete, the superb Mexican. So that would be difficult. But it's been a one-sided sort of shutout, if you like, from Nick Ball. It's been a tremendous display. He's just got to see it out.
It's all about progressing through the levels, isn't it, when you're a young fighter chasing a world title shot. Every obstacle put in your way, you've got to find a way to get over it. He's impressively managed to do that tonight against a man full of experience, a man who's held world titles, a man who still believes that he can get back to the top of the division as well. Nick Ball has dominated this fight right from the opening bell.
And I was at Dogbay, probably won't have expected Nick Ball to be this ferocious late on. I mean, that was a superb jab. What a shot that was from Ball.
The timing was outstanding, wasn't it?
Yeah, just a simple, basic jab hitting the target. So he does the basics very well. And like I say, Dogbay, he would have expected Ball to slow down, but he certainly hasn't.
Ball's combinations have been so impressive, especially when he starts at the body and works his way up and then arrows that uppercut through the gloves.
It's maintaining the gap as well, Fletch, while he's doing that. That's the difficult part, because you fall in. If you miss the target, you actually fall in. So you've got to hit the target, keep the punches going.
Even there, with his back to the ropes, Richie, he was the man that fought his way off it. He was letting the punches go, despite the fact he was boxed in a little bit. Into the final minute, well into the final minute. And this looks like a comprehensive victory tonight for Nick Ball, and another step along the road to a world title challenge, and maybe, just maybe, a world title belt in 2024. Gotta say, Richie, I love watching him. You don't see him in a bad fight, do you?
No, not at all. Action packed every round. And this, you know, been one-sided, but this hasn't been an easy fight. Dogbay's a class act himself.
Absolutely. Full credit to him for still being in there. Well, there's the final bell. And what a good job that was done by Nick Ball tonight.
Great job. He'd be really, really pleased, and so will Paul Stevenson, his coach, because that was a superb display. The variety of punching, his technique, the power, the timing, it was all there against a world-class opponent, a former world champion, who's only lost contests at world level. So that was a good display from Nick Ball. You know, he goes on, and this kid, yeah, we're going to see him in a world title fight pretty soon, I should think.
I wonder what the rest of the fighters around him in the division think when they look at him, because whatever happens, you know you're getting a hard night's work against him. You get nothing easy against that man, no matter who you are.
Well, he hasn't even sat down, has he, in between rounds, so he's extremely fit, confidence in his fitness. He produces power shots late on in the contest, combinations as well. He's got a very good variety, and occasionally does the basics well behind that jab, which is so important.
He's just done 12 rounds, Richie, at a ferocious pace. He's thrown a million punches while he's in there. He's never stopped throwing leather. And he's stood there now, looking like he could do another 12.
Yeah, and it's not as if it's against an opponent who hasn't really fought back. Dogbay, you know, give a good account himself. Also, powerful man, dangerous man, caught Nick Ball with a couple of good shots. But Ball come through it, and like I say, he's put in a punch-perfect display there, really.
OK, then, let's get the decision. Thomas Triver is ready to bring it to us.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of boxing, we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge Kevin Parker scores it 118 to 109. Judge Kieran McCann scores it 116 to 111. And Judge Mark Lyson scores it 119 to 108. All in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And still, WBC Silver Featherweight champion and winner of the final eliminator for the WBC Featherweight World Championship, Nick the Routine Ball!
So Nick Ball can say goodbye to 2023, can enjoy his Christmas dinner, and then when 2023 becomes 2024, he can look forward to a world title challenge and an opportunity to get his hands on the WBC belt. The one card that did surprise me was Kieran McCann's 116, 111. It felt way wider than that. I thought the other two cards were more realistic.
Yeah, a bit of a sympathy vote, wasn't it, that one? But yeah, that's the way he saw it. But it was a clear, clear points victory there for Nick Moore. That's a real good display of boxing.
If you look at him, Richie, you've seen him tonight. We've talked about the strengths. We've talked about how good he is. If you want to see him develop, what does he still need to work on?
Well, you know what, Fletch? The way he's been boxing, it's a punch-perfect display. So I don't know what to say about that, because I think he does the basics well. I think he boxes very well at mid-short range. Even at long range beyond that jab, he does it exceptionally well. He's a very explosive character. Maybe a little bit more head movement, but hey, I'm just picking flies here, mate. He's doing brilliant.
Well, there he is with the belt and with the T-shirt on. And we can head into the ring now, I think, and join JD, because he's got Nick Ball and he's got Frank Warren with him as well.
Nick, more than anything else, I know you're having an opportunity to speak with Frank, but I just want you to take this in, the atmosphere, the emotion, your performance in there tonight. How are you feeling after getting the victory?
Feeling good. It was a good performance from myself. Just had to keep me cool and feel like I controlled the fight for the full 12 rounds, yeah, so made up with it.
When you think about Isaac Dogbe, and obviously him being a former world champion, does this firmly announce yourself on the world stage now?
Yeah, definitely, because I feel like I've just controlled that fight there at a world level, and this is world level, and it doesn't get no bigger than this, only for world titles now, and I've just put myself in the position to do that, so it's only good going from here.
It seems like the perfect time to bring in Hall of Fame promoter Frank. Frank, at this moment in time, he's already said it, he wants only world titles from here. You see the silver WBC sitting on his strap right there, but where can he go from here now?
Well, he's just become the mandatory for the title, for the full title. I mean, that was a consummate professional performance. He never put a foot wrong, nice and composed, controlled the fight, he's got controlled aggression. You know, he's a super, super fighter. I love him, love watching him box. And he's there now, it's not the next fight, it's certainly the fight after will be for the world title, and we'll make sure it's over here.
More than anything else, I know there's going to be so many fans watching at home and so many viewers, as well as the atmosphere in here, but I could almost imagine there's going to be Ray Vargas who's sitting there watching at home right now. Do you have a statement or a message you want to send to him?
I don't have a message to none of them. I think me being myself, I'm not much of a big talker. Me performances let me do the talking, so you'll find out when I get in the ring with them.
No doubt about it, he's not a man of many words, but he's a man of some big action, and I'm sure he enjoyed that one tonight.
Paul Stevenson has done a magnificent job as his manager and trainer, and the team done a brilliant job.
You hear it, Laura, it's a team effort down here. Incredible performance from you again tonight, Nick.